We are in the third part of the thermometer application creation for Android. We have defined some specific attributes for our thermometer component, so we need to define them in an attributes file located in the resource value directory. We create this file. Then we create the thermometer stealable element and we define attributes with correct formats. The radius, which is with dimension format, outer color, middle color, and inner color. Now we can create the user interface of our thermometer application. We are going to use this thermometer view in the activity main layout. For the thermometer component, we define the width and height, then we center it horizontally. We define finally the specific attributes like inner color, middle color, outer color, and the radius. Now it's time to write the Java code of our main activity for the thermometer application. Our main activity implements the sensor event listener to get notified from the changes of the sensor for the temperature. We implement the sensor event listener interface method. The onSensorChange and the onAccuracyChange methods. We define fields for the main activity. With the SensorManager, the thermometer component, and the temperature field to store the temperature value. In the onCreate method, we get the thermometer component from the layout, and we get the SensorManager instance by calling the getSystemService method with the context.sensorService constant in parameter. We call the load ambient temperature method in the onResume method of the main activity of our application. Now we are writing the Java code for the load ambient temperature, but just before, in the onPause method, we call an unregisterAll method to unregister the sensor listener, which is the current activity here. In the load ambient temperature, we get a default sensor for the type ambient temperature. If the sensor is not null and so present on the running device, we register the current activity on the sensor manager to get notified from the changes with the sensor delay fastest. Otherwise, we display a message to the user to tell him that the device has no ambient temperature sensor. Like said previously, we unregister the current activity from the sensor manager by calling its unregisterListener method. In the onSensorChange method, we get notified to the value changes of the ambient temperature sensor. The first element of the array is the temperature, so we get it. And we set new temperature on the thermometer component by calling the setCurrentTemp method. We don't forget to update the value of the temperature in the action bar. Now we can try our Android application in the Android emulator by clicking on the Run button. We wait during the Gradle build. The APK is installing. The Gradle build takes some time. Okay, there is no ambient sensor on the emulator. So we need to try our application on a real device with such sensor like the Samsung Galaxy S4, or we can use a little hack to test our thermometer application. The little hack would be to add a method to simulate the temperature changes. In the onResume method of the activity, we call the simulate ambient temperature method that we are going to write. For this method, we add a timer in the fields. And we write the Java code for the simulate ambient temperature method. And in the onRegisterAll method, don't forget to cancel the timer to avoid to call the simulate ambient temperature method. So we are going to use the timer to schedule the call of a method at fixed rate and change the temperature value on the component. In the method, we create a new timer and we fix a cell a call in 3 seconds. In the run method of the timer task, we generate a random value for the temperature between minus 10 and 35. Note that we use randint method located in the utils class. With a new temperature, we choose to update the user interface in a run on UI thread call. We set the new temperature on the thermometer component and we change the value of the title. Now we can try our application by clicking on the run button on our Android Studio. Wait during the Gradle build. Okay, so the thermometer is displayed and we are going to wait for the temperature changes. Good, it works great. Our thermometer application for Android is great. That's all for the tutorial. Don't hesitate to subscribe to the SRL channel to discover more tutorials on Android development.